Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us today. This year is not like any other, not even when we set out to celebrate our unique public Montessori school and all of the people that make up our school community. My name is Meryl Levin, and I'm the executive director here at Mill Falls, New Hampshire's first public Montessori school. We are in our 8th year of operation. We have gathered all of you here today to celebrate the joy and wonder of learning, to recognize the commitment of our staff, and to celebrate some important moments in the lives of our students. This event is taking the place of so many of our usual end-of-year gatherings, our very popular annual leadership fundraising breakfast, our beloved kindergarten tea, our in-school step-up day, and our 6th grade graduation, among many others. We had to think way outside the box to come up with a format that could recognize everyone's hard work and be virtual. Our solution? We've combined some of our favorite parts of the events that I just mentioned into a new event special for this year. I don't know about you, but I've been looking almost every day for silver linings during this new normal. And the first one that came to mind today was, boy, the parking sure was easy. If we were here in person, you would likely be glancing at your program right about now. So let me help you with that. We will begin with our program in a few minutes by sharing the voices of students in a song that we feel is much like our school anthem. It's called Light a Candle for Peace. I'll be back after that to speak with you about some unique aspects of our program. Then we will move to our youngest learners, enjoying a performance by our kindergartners of Eric Carle's classic, The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Our educational program director, Laura Robleski, will then orient us toward a video that is the next segment, which recognizes those students who are moving from one program level to another, from kindergarten to lower elementary or from lower elementary to upper elementary. Laura will then return with a moving speech focused on our 6-year students, but with an important message for all of us. Each of our 6-year students who are preparing to step out will then be recognized by their classroom teachers. And we'll return to music and a slideshow of the year as we close out. I want to first say that this event was made possible through a wonderful partnership. Derryfield School senior Tiana Content has made this event her senior project and produced every one of the segments you will see today. She is a generous and kind person, detail-oriented and full of humor, wonder, and thank goodness, patience. Thank you, T, for all you have done to make this happen. Thanks to the Derryfield team for your amazing partnership, and thanks Gabby and Ruzola for introducing me to the amazing Tiana. Of course, I also send a special shout out to our dedicated staff. You work your hearts out every day for our kids, and this year you doubled down on that promise, even as we ran our school remotely. I'm honored to work among you all, even from my kitchen table. And I also want to send an extra huge thank you to our families who have worked with us always and extra hard since mid-March in support of the children who are learning remotely. I'd next like to thank our hardworking school board trustees and foundation board members. These folks work behind the scenes, keeping our organization in good order and in good standing. Thank you all. Finally, please join me in thanking our event sponsors. These folks have supported us generously for years and years. Knowing that they have our backs means the world to us. Thank you, Susan Contos and Carol DeCola at Accurate Title. Thank you, Newton Kershaw at Elm Grove Properties. Thank you, Dan Calegari, a longtime trustee on the board. And thank you, Will Kanteres at Kanteres Real Estate. Many of you, our Montessori Morning Tea guests, have already donated in support of our program today. And for that, we thank you. If you have not yet done so, we hope you will consider making a donation. Your contributions help support our unique public Montessori school. As you've heard me say so many times, we are required to make up the difference between public funding, which is less than half of what traditional public schools get per child, and the actual cost of providing our high-quality education to our students. Thank you for all you can share. You can visit www.millfalls.org and make a donation there. We will also send you information in a follow-up email, and you'll see some things posted here as well. It is my hope that today's event will touch you as your support touches us. Okay, without further delay, let me pause here and introduce our Mill Falls songbirds. No better way to start the day than hearing your young voices.
Light a candle for peace, light a candle for love, light a candle that shines all the way around the world, light a candle for me, light a candle for you, that our wish for world peace will one day come true. Light a candle for peace, light a candle for love, light a candle that shines all the way around the world. Light a candle for me, light a candle for you, that our wish for world peace will one day come true.
That was beautiful. In this new era, as we're forced to live with the presence of COVID-19 without treatment or immunization yet, our paramount concern is the safety of our children, their families, and our staff at Mill Falls. And as we exist in this new normal, the challenge we are faced with is maintaining the integrity of our 120 plus year old Montessori pedagogy, using the tools of today and implementing it in this once-in-a-lifetime moment from about 35 staff homes into about 142 school family homes. But regardless of where school is taking place, it is our Mill Falls mission to deliver young citizens who are academically accomplished, independent learners, who are also caring members of our community. For us at Mill Falls, those naturally blend together and are highly supported by the Montessori approach. And we're pleased to report we've had another very successful year despite every curveball that's been thrown at us. Those of you who have visited our school know that there are many explicit and detailed techniques that set Montessori apart from a traditional school setting. Many of you have heard me speak in tours or information sessions as I describe the Montessori classroom looking more like a living room than a classroom. Well, never before has that statement been more true. Living rooms, dining rooms, kitchen tables, backyards. It is, as I've been saying since mid-March, a lot for all of us to have taken on. But every member of our community and our extended Mill Falls family has leaned in, taken on this extraordinary challenge, all in support of our kids. And isn't that what it's about anyway? It's been a while since our last read-in, our last school event, our last regular school day. So let's take a moment and bask in the amazingly rich tradition that is Montessori. Some of those headlines include mixed-age classrooms filled with hands-on materials which help students understand concepts large and small. Our students have freedom to explore subjects but still meet academic expectations. The annual establishment of classroom codes of behavior are developed and agreed upon by students and their teachers. As our students mature through our program, they strengthen their sense of ownership of their education. And daily, they learn executive functioning skills and time management. They sharpen their skills of working together and maintaining our peaceful and nurturing environment. We are, as I said before, just about to complete our eighth year. With hard work and your amazing support, we have accomplished a lot. We've built a public tuition-free Montessori school accessible to all New Hampshire families, regardless of financial status, cultural identity, or life experiences. We've built a diverse learning community, which reflects the various ethnicities, economic strata, life experiences, and learning styles found in Southern New Hampshire. We've built a robust and challenging curriculum, which merges Common Core requirements with the Montessori approach. We've capitalized on the Montessori grace and courtesy curriculum, which supports the whole child. And we've built a deliberate culture, which emphasizes the importance of responsible citizenship on the personal, small scale, and more broadly. Montessori wrote a great deal about her philosophy, so much of which is present in this quote. The greatest gift we can give our children are the roots of responsibility and the wings of independence. But independence in a classroom and beyond, which by the way, ultimately leads to ownership of one's learning, must be taught and nourished in environments deliberately set up for such success and by teachers trained to do so. Our goal at Mill Falls is that our Montessori students will learn the skills to access curriculum independently. To do so, they're taught in small group lessons, organized by ability, not necessarily by grade. They then spend much of their school day practicing the lessons using hands-on materials, which are self-correcting. They work this way until they're able to let go of the materials because they have mastered a lesson, large or small. This individualized approach builds student confidence, and so everyone can access challenges as well as a sense of success, whatever their level. Embedded in the Mill Falls curriculum is the emphasis on each child's social and emotional health and development. It begins with an early introduction and consistent practice of grace, courtesy, and respect, literally curricular components that introduce the children to building their emotional intelligence from the day they step through our doors. Today, more than ever, we need to pause and consider these words, grace, courtesy, and respect. They are deeply deserving of our time and exploration, of the important role they play in the establishment of student success now and in the future. As adults, we must model for the children, and ultimately, the children will model for one another. Everyone should be held accountable. The notion that if we grow kindness and empathy in the minds of our students, then they will lead with that as they mature. It will build not just their sense of the world and the importance of tolerance and patience and empathy, all of which are so important, but curiosity as well. And at the end of the day, we know we're doing our jobs if we have turned the curiosity light on in the minds and souls of our students. Dr. Montessori firmly believed that the education of even the youngest child does not aim at preparing him or her for school, but for life. I'm very proud of our rigorous academic program. It is the setting of cultural norms and expectations, as well as our peaceful setting that I hold dear to my heart and I have missed the most on a daily basis this spring while we have been working and schooling from home. It gives our students, our teachers, and our staff the courage and curiosity to connect to the power of their imaginations, growing their roots of responsibility and wings of independence. I know we all look forward to being able to safely reopen our school doors once again and spend time together face to face. On a personal note, I just want to say how much I have missed our daily life at school. I miss seeing and interacting with the children. I miss their voices and their funny jokes. I miss interacting with our parents who give me advice, ideas, and some criticism. I miss walking around school to admire and observe and photograph our amazing staff as they practice their craft with wisdom and grace. I thank each of you for all you bring to our school community and for all of our guests for being with us this morning. At this time, I'd like to share a beautiful video that I know will make your heart sing. A small technological wonder, again, thank you, Tiana, and thanks to our Kinder families, their teachers, Miss Kristen and Miss Kayla, in homage to Mr. Carl, herewith, the Very Hungry Caterpillar.
The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carl.
In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop! Out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food.
On Monday, he threw one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he threw two pears, but he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he threw three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he threw four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he threw five oranges, but he was still hungry.
On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one piece of watermelon. That night he had a stomachache.
The next day was Sunday. Again, the caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf. And after that, he felt much better. Now he wasn't hungry anymore. And he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big fat caterpillar.
He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks, then nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and became a beautiful butterfly.
Good morning. My name is Laura Robleski. I'm the Educational Program Director for Mill Falls, and I have been at MFCS for 8 years, affording me the privilege of observing our students grow from kindergartners to sixth graders. I want to welcome and thank our MFCS community, families, friends, supporters, and of course our students for being here. We are so incredibly excited to be together for the first time in quite a while. Traditionally, at the end of the year, we hold a moving up ceremony for our rising students. Rising meaning changing grades to a new level of Montessori. As part of this ceremony, we honor each student by sharing their name and have them greeted by the existing student in the next level with a candle representing peace. Given our remote status, we know that candles aren't possible via video. But we still wanted to continue the tradition of acknowledging our rising kinders moving to lower elementary and rising third years moving to upper elementary by sharing pictures of each student. We are so proud of your achievements and look forward to next year. Please welcome the rising class of kinders followed by the rising class of third years. Today I have the honor of guiding our 60-year cohort off to bigger and better adventures beyond our walls. Thinking back to September 2012, the concept of having a thriving, developed school seemed far off. Some of these students graduating today have been with us since kindergarten, and they were ready to embark on this learning journey called Montessori for the very first time. Others joined us along the way, mostly in the upper elementary, but they acclimated quickly. It seems they've always been with us from the first day because they are such a united community. 8 of the 13 students can now say they've completed a full elementary Montessori cycle, both lower and upper elementary completed. They have the privilege of participating in all 3 stages of learning, starting from the immersion of concrete concepts, moving to the abstract, and finishing with the role as a mentor and guide as the oldest student in the room. I am so incredibly proud of these students' accomplishments and growths over the years. It's difficult to say that they are even the same as when they arrived. And today, it's time for our students to take what they have gained over the years and put it to good use in their new course of education. With that, I have written a letter to the 6th graders with some words of wisdom offered by Dr. Maria Montessori. Dear 6th years of Olympic, Everglades, and Zion classrooms, each and every one of your personalities has added to our community. I have fond memories of each of you, and I hope that you will be leaving our school with many of the same. From the first ever Olympics reenactment to the first ever passion projects completed this past spring. But most importantly, conquering your fears and becoming leaders in your own right, you are all creative and special students. With that, I would like to offer a few quotes written by Dr. Maria Montessori. And you might be able to use these in your future endeavors. Number 1, the essence of independence is to be able to do something for oneself. Does this sound familiar? I hope so. Your teachers always encourage that you make your own way, no one else. Who would do it for you? You are in control of your learning. Imagination, number 2, does not become great until human beings give the courage and the strength to use it to create. Always ask questions, think outside the box, be the person in the room that thinks differently. Number 3, scientific observation then has established that education is not what the teacher gives. Education is a natural process spontaneously carried out by the human individual and is acquired not by listening to words, but by experiences upon the environment. Remember, you don't have to be passive in your learning. Take in what's offered, engage, and go beyond. Decide to go beyond what's expected. Choose to learn for knowledge, not because you were asked to. Number 4, from the child itself, he will learn how to perfect himself as educator. Remember, your job is not to just have knowledge, but to share knowledge. Take that responsibility seriously. Teach what you have mastered, just as you've done here as the leader in your classrooms. Number 5, we shall walk together on this path of life, for all things are part of the universe and are connected with each other to form one whole unity. Always be graceful, courteous, and respectful in all ways. We as humans and friends are connected with all. Today's actions impact tomorrow's lives. And now more than ever, do we see that on a daily basis. So today, as you watch this celebration, know this is the end of one part of your life's journey, but also the start of another exciting segment. We know you will always be here. We will always be here as guides, but you are ready to launch to your next endeavors. Enjoy what comes next, and don't forget us. We're always here. In true celebration, we have compiled a video. Each teacher speaks about their students and the impact each of you have had on those around you. Please listen on for the celebration of our graduating sixth grade class of Mill Falls Charter School. Congratulations, and we will miss you all. Please, please enjoy your summer.
Hi, Amadou. We've had you in class for 2 years, and I've really enjoyed having you as a student. You are so smart, and the way you learn and how eager you are to learn new things and the drive you have to just like get more and more knowledge every single day is so impressive. You have made such tremendous growth in such a short amount of time. I hope you know just how brilliant you really are. My wish for you going forward is that you realize how talented, charming, kind, friendly you are, and that you never forget that, and that you never doubt it for a second, because it's so true, and you have such great potential to do such amazing things, and I just can't wait to see which path you decide to take.
Hi, Amadou. So I've only had the pleasure of knowing you since September, but in these short few months, I've learned just how smart you are and how dedicated you are. And like Miss Laura said, you're driven, and that's such an amazing quality that you have. I'm going to miss your smile, your little smirk, when we embarrass you and you kind of give us that little like, don't say that, it's really embarrassing. I'm gonna miss watching you play sports at recess. And I really hope that you continue to get advance in soccer, maybe join the school team. That way you can travel and meet new friends. Watch out middle school, because here comes Amadou. Congratulations.
Hi, Charlotte. I know you love attention, so here it goes. It has been really great watching you grow over these past 3 years. It's a unique thing to be a student teacher, have a student for 3 years and have a teacher for 3 years. So I feel lucky to have had you in my class. You are kind, you are incredibly dependable, and you are so funny, although I feel like it took some time for that to come out or for us to figure out how funny you are. You have a great dry sense of humor. So thank you for sharing that with us. I've also loved watching you be involved in all the sports games at recess. It reminds me of myself at that age. So keep that up. We will miss you. Congrats.
Hey, Charlotte. I will miss you very much next year, of course. I enjoyed having you so much in class and getting to know you, and also in reading group. You were always there with fun ideas. You always had something to say about whatever we were reading, and I always appreciated that very much. I loved that you were always willing to help another student or a teacher like me that might have needed help with something. So thank you so much. I will miss you next year, and good luck.
Hi, Patrick. Patrick, you have really come into yourself this past year. Year one, I feel like I remember you as a shy little fourth grader who didn't really talk much. And now year three, you talk a lot. You have made some really great friends along the way. You're not afraid to speak your mind or share your opinion, and that is a really good quality. So take that confidence with you into middle school. I will miss your recess silliness and the creative, imaginative games that you invent. And we will miss you, and congratulations.
Hey, Patrick. I will miss you as well. And you were another one that I got the joy of having in a reading group. And you also always had some great ideas, always something to add, something that you were thinking about, a character or a situation in the book. So that was awesome. I will also miss your vast knowledge of D&D and how you really brought that enthusiasm to indoor recess games, which really caught on with the other kids in class. So I think that was really fun for them to have that game and for you to be the resident expert. So good luck next year. I will miss you.
Elizabeth, congratulations on all your accomplishments in the upper L. You came in as a shy fourth grader and are leaving as a confident sixth grader. So take that confidence with you into middle school. You will need it and it will take you far. I love that when you are dedicated and passionate about something, you really produce some fantastic work. I'm going to miss your honesty, your beautiful artwork, and your passion for your artwork, as well as your wild imaginative play at recess. I'll never lose the visual of you guys with the balls on your head, with the hoods. So thank you for that. We'll miss you at Mill Falls and congratulations.
Hey, Elizabeth. It was wonderful getting to know you and having you as a student this year and another one of my reading group members. You definitely always had great things to say during reading group. You had great ideas and great insight. So I will miss that. I also loved seeing your fantastic artwork and reading and hearing the creative writing pieces that you would share with our class. So keep continuing that and best of luck next year. I'll miss you.
Hi, Parker. I know you also love attention, so I'll keep this short for you. It has been great watching you grow over these past 3 years. I would have to say your biggest accomplishment is how much you were able to open up socially. And because of that, you've made some really awesome friendships in our classroom and even some outside of our classroom. So take that confidence with you into middle school and just remember the friendships that you did make here. I'll miss your love for nonfiction reading. Most gravitate towards fiction, but you would be the first to pick up a biography, an autobiography, historical fiction book, book about dogs. So it was really, I love that about you. So we will miss you and congratulations.
Hey Parker, congratulations. I also got to enjoy having you in reading group. And as much as you may not have wanted to, I did appreciate when you would participate and share your ideas because they were always great. I will also miss watching you out at recess with your friends. And I wish you the best next year and good luck. We will miss you.
Hi, Natalie. I have had the privilege of watching you grow for the past 3 years. And it has been such a joy to see the amazing transformation that you've made from your beginning of fourth grade all the way to the end of sixth grade. You have turned into such a kind, hardworking, honest young lady. And I just am constantly impressed by your work ethic, the way you learn, your sense of humor. I've really enjoyed having you in my class, and I'm really gonna miss you when you leave.
Hi, Natalie. So I've only known you since September, but I feel like in those few months, I have learned that you are smart and beautiful and kind. I know you're going to soar in middle school and you're going to let everybody see the light that you have inside of you and it's going to shine. I hope that you join activities and clubs and sports teams because there you'll meet new friends and meet other teachers. You're going to excel in gymnastics, and I hope you continue helping at gymnastics with the younger kids because I think younger children really look up to you.
That's true.
Keep your head held high and let those positive vibes shine.
And congratulations.
Congratulations, Natalie.
Come visit because we'll miss you.
Tyler, congratulations on everything you've accomplished in the upper L. It's been wonderful watching you grow into the young man you've become, and I have no doubt that you will do amazing things in your future. I'm going to miss your humor, your honesty, and even your sarcasm. You bring some funny jokes to math lessons, and that is appreciated. I'm going to miss your passion for sports at recess. It's a great quality to have, to take with you as an athlete, and it'll take you far in all your sports endeavors. So work hard, come back and visit. We will miss you. Congratulations.
Hey, Tyler. It's been great getting to know you this year. It's been wonderful to see you grow and mature as the year went on. What I loved was that you were always happy and you were always in a good mood. And I think that makes such a difference in a classroom. So thank you for that happy presence that you always brought to our day. Good luck next year.
Hey, Calum. How are you,
bud? Hi, Calum.
I asked you how you are, but you can't really respond back. Anyway, just wanted to give you a little message because it has been such a pleasure watching you grow over these past 3 years. I think in fourth grade, you were always thoughtful, sweet, and a little shy. And through the past couple of years, I've really seen you turn into more confident. I've seen your confidence come out. You are always the first guy to lend a helping hand to everybody. You are our tech support, my math operations man. I've loved our off-topic conversations, and I'm really, really going to miss you, bud.
So, Calum, I've only known you this 1 year, but it has been such a joy to get to know you. I like how you are so thoughtful. That is the one thing that I really admire about you, that you really think before you speak. Some of us have a hard time with that. Mm-hmm. And you're so thoughtful and your leadership is there. You're quiet, but people do look to you as a leader. So that is something you need to be really proud of. That's and awesome. I really enjoyed having you in reading group. I always liked your insight. Again, your quiet thoughtfulness. And I wish the best for you. I know you're going to do amazing things. So
absolutely.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, buddy. We're going to miss you.
We definitely will miss you.
Bye.
Bye. Congratulations, Kaylee. It has been an absolute joy to have you in class for 3 years. I've enjoyed watching you grow, both literally and figuratively, into a beautiful young lady. You have made some really awesome friendships along the way, and that's been so nice to see those form. You're always so kind, and it's a quality that's going to take you far in life, so keep that up. Thank you for being such a great student and always so dedicated to your work and to your learning. And we are going to miss you so much. Congratulations.
Kaylee, I will miss you also so much. And again, it was such a pleasure to get to know you. And I loved having you, especially in reading group, because you always had something good to offer. And I will very much miss your sweet and kind personality. You are always so wonderful to everybody in the class. Good luck next year.
Congratulations, Camden. So we just want to say a couple things as a farewell to you. It has been a wonderful 3 years getting to know you and watching you grow into the fine young man that you are. You are kind, you are genuine, and you are so, so funny. Things I'm going to miss about you, I'm going to miss your wit, your sarcasm, your presentations. You have a real ability to capture the audience when you're presenting to the class. And I know I will miss that, as I'm sure your classmates will miss that too. I'm also going to miss reading your writing pieces. You have a wonderful enthusiasm about writing. And that was just really nice to see and see your love for writing. So I'm looking forward to seeing where that takes you in your future. Thank you for being such a wonderful student. Congratulations, you will be missed.
So I too will miss you very much, Camden. I enjoyed getting to know you so much this year. You were such a wonderful part of the classroom and you were always helpful to me when I needed it. I will especially miss our chats about movies and books and podcasts. Good luck next year.
Hello, Owen. It is us for you.
Hello, Mr. Moshe.
We just wanted to give you a little message. It has been so much fun having you in Zion for the past 3 years. You are so funny. I don't think we need to tell you that. You're witty and you are one of the best pranksters ever. So it has just been so much fun watching you evolve from a shy little inventor in fourth year with luscious locks to your sixth grade preteen self. You always show up as a leader when you need to, and it has just been so great having you, and I am very much going to miss all of the fun that we've had.
So, Owen, I guess we knew each other when you were in fourth grade. You did the drama club and with your long, luscious hair, and you asked me to call you Jeff. I didn't know why, but I appreciated the uniqueness that you brought. And now knowing you as a sixth grader, I am so impressed with your intelligence and your leadership and your creativity, and you will be sorely missed. So congratulations.
Yes, congratulations, bud.
We're gonna Good job, buddy.
Bye. Hi, Audrey.
Hi, Audrey.
It's just, you know, us.
Hello, we miss you.
We definitely miss you. We just wanted to give you a little message of love. It has been so cool to watch you grow over the past 3 years. You went from shy and quiet, but always one that really stood up for what they believed in. And it's been nice to see that evolve over time and to a much more confident, capable, creative, wonderful young lady. I am going to so miss our chats together. And I'm going to miss you terribly, so you better come visit.
And I've only known you for this year, Audrey, but it has been an absolute delight. And I just love how everyone in the class just absolutely loves you. Yes. Maybe you don't realize that, but it's true. You are so likable and kind and such a nice, loyal friend. You're funny, low-key funny, as the kids would say. I love reading all of your writing. You're an amazing writer. You need to keep it up. Keep working hard at that. You're so creative. And yeah, you need to come visit us, okay?
Always. Yes. So we miss you. We're going to miss you.
You. And good congratulations.
Yes, congratulations.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Haley. I've only known you since September, but in this short time, I've learned that you're kind, thoughtful, smart, and very silly. I think that in middle school, you're going to soar because you have a personality that just shines. You're friendly and you're kind, and everyone loves you. You can light up the room with just your smile and your positivity. So I hope you join clubs and play sports, meet new friends, and engage with other adults. And I'm going to miss you.
Haley, you have been in the Olympic room for 3 years, and it's been such a delight to learn with you, to watch you grow. You have such an incredible spirit and work ethic, and I always love that moment when you learn something new. That sheer excitement and joy that you get from mastering something is really just been, it's been a pleasure to watch. I'm gonna miss our silly jokes. I'm gonna miss that giggle that is just completely contagious. And you have been such a great role model for your classmates and a good friend to all of your peers. And you're gonna do great in middle school, and it's gonna be phenomenal. You're going to have all these opportunities to show how creative and talented you are. And I'm very excited for you to go off to middle school and enjoy all of those new opportunities. So congratulations. And also avocado.
Avocado.
When we think of our students, we think of their future and the future of our school. With your commitment now, you can help us and them imagine all that they can be and all that can come next. With your support at Mill Falls, we nurture each student's social and emotional development alongside their academic pursuits so that we can deliver young students who are academically accomplished and caring members of our community so that one day they too will be able to pay it all forward. As you sign off today, please keep in mind that this tea is a stand-in for the many significant fundraisers we do each spring. We usually raise between $50,000 and $60,000, so please donate as generously as you are able to today to support our tomorrows. Thank you so very much. We're going to finish up with a final slideshow looking at the year, some beautiful music. My deep and heartfelt thanks. Stay safe, and please stay in touch. Thank you.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop. When you dance, 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 feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, 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 come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance. Rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. You're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop. When you dance, 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 feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, 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 come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance. I can't stop the, I can't stop the feeling. Nothing I can see but you when you dance.